My name is Sydney Brown. I'm a junior in atmospheric science in the Earth, Atmospheric, and Planetary Science Department in the College of Science at Purdue University.
My name is Emma Miller. I'm a senior studying atmospheric science and planetary sciences here in the College of Science.
I'm Dr. Robin Tanamachi. I'm an associate professor of atmospheric science here in the Purdue College of Science.
So here at Purdue, especially in the Department of Earth, Atmospheric, and Planetary Sciences, one of the big draws for me personally was the small class sizes. So there's about 6 students to 1 professor, a 6-to-1 ratio, meaning that, you know, once you get through your tough engineering level courses, you get to have a really individualized experiences with your professors. They're here for you to help you grow as a person and as a professional, which is super helpful for me for career development.
Well, I strongly recommend that all undergraduates engage in at least 1 undergraduate research experience here. At some point during the 4 years that they're here earning their degree, spend a semester working closely with a professor on a specialized project and then present that in, say, the Purdue Undergraduate Research Expo, maybe publish it in the Journal of Purdue Undergraduate Research. Any of those items are going to be preserved online and are items that you can point to prospective employers as examples of your work and your professional development.
Some research opportunities that I've taken advantage of at Purdue were through my classes. So in my EAPS 523 radar meteorology class last spring, I got to ground truth our very own XTERRA radar. We were able to take ground-based precipitation estimates and convert that into a number that related to what the radar saw. So that way we were able to see how accurate our radar was and what it was seeing at the same time, how much rainfall or snowfall was falling.
So I've taken advantage of a lot of research opportunities here. I started working last spring with Dr. Tanamachi, working on kind of an extension of a different project. So in our last iteration of radar meteorology, she set it up as a course-based undergraduate research experience. So the entire course was set up to provide research experience for all the students within it. So I got to help write Python scripts, which were sent out to the entire class, and they processed the data for me for my individual project, which was using the radar data to kind of determine if data quality changed given the temperature change here in West Lafayette. So I got to work with the radar data as well as data from the airport. And that's kind of expanded into me presenting at the expo, and I'm going to the American Meteorological Society's student conference in January to present that as well. And right now I'm still working with her on a different project. We're doing a case study on a tornadic storm that happened here in June 25th, 2021. Basically, there was a tornado that happened in the northeast corner of Tippecanoe County, and our radar here on campus noticed it and detected that, but the radar from Indianapolis, which provides us our warnings, didn't detect it, and so it was unwarned for the first time that it was on the ground. So I'm working with that data from our radar as well as data from the Indianapolis radar and comparing how having a smaller radar in these gap filling areas is helpful for warning decision processes, like getting out warnings to the public.
So there's lots of opportunities to attend scientific conferences and big professional conferences here in the region and also nationally. I try to support students attending, say for example, the American Meteorological Society's annual student conference, which is a very student focused conference that involves presentations of student research as well as a series of professional development seminars that students can attend and learn about things like applying to graduate school, getting more involved in field programs, and basically meeting with some of the best and the brightest minds in our field.
Through the Purdue University Meteorological Association, I've been able to make a ton of connections either with the federal sector or the private sector or broadcast meteorologists. Just being able to reach out to the National Weather Service, those broadcast meteorologists, has allowed me to make connections. It's showed them that I am a personal person and that I can work towards making events that work for everybody, and also keeping them happy while we're trying to make events, and just staying in touch with them after the event happens, just being able to say, you know, thank you for coming to our event, shows that I'm good at following up, shows that I'm personable, and hopefully that I would be a great future co-worker, which is really exciting to be able to get the contact information for these people and just be able to talk to them and show them that I'm a responsible adult that is capable of making events.
One of the main networking opportunities for me has been my relationship with Dr. Robin Tanamachi. She's been my research mentor for the last spring semester, this fall semester, and hopefully going forward into the next spring. And she's been really helpful for helping me understand what I want to do leaving school, and also just helping my knowledge about radars and Python and literally any science thing you could think of. She's been there, done that, and she's been really helpful for me meeting new people for graduate school and meeting people within the entire science and atmospheric science field, which has been really awesome. Additionally, this past summer, I got to go to the National Center for Atmospheric Research's undergraduate leadership workshop. So I got to meet with two leadership mentors there, as well as students from around the country who are also doing meteorology or atmospheric science. And we got to take leadership training, how to do work with groups, how to lead groups, how to work with other people, as well as getting diversity, equity, inclusion training, and just, you know, getting to visit lots of different labs and meeting with new people who work there, which is super helpful. One of the leaders there runs a kind of like an internship, which is super helpful for getting to know him and what their programs are doing there. I also here at Purdue got to do the undergraduate research expo, which has been super helpful for meeting people outside of my field. It's really interdisciplinary, so getting to meet people who work with research as a whole and how they write papers and how they present their work has been super helpful for me.
So we have a program that allows us to connect students with internships, either locally or nationally. There's lots of virtual options for students who may not have the wherewithal or the ability to travel someplace. You can participate in virtual workshops, virtual conferences, and virtual internships with certain companies. But whenever it's possible, we also will try to support students attending those events in person and getting that in-person experience of going out in the field and collecting data or participating in a field campaign with collaborators from another institution. We try to get students out of the classroom as much as possible.
So a lot of the classes here have final projects, especially within the EAPS department, and we get to work with other companies and their data to fulfill the requirements that we need to have for the class. So for example, in a lower level instrumentation class, we got to work with the Wabash Heartland Innovative Network, and we got to use their data in Python scripts to be able to process their data and compare it to stuff that we saw here in West Lafayette, which was really awesome. So Python, learning Python, building skills like that in those class projects has been really helpful and definitely looks good on your resume for employers.
So if I could go back to my freshman year self and give myself one piece of advice, it would be to take more computer science, because just about every aspect of atmospheric science is going to be steeped in computing, whether you're, you know, computing statistics for climate change, whether you're doing calculations for a class, whether you're generating maps for a class. Any of those things is going to require a pretty competent handling of even a high-level programming language like Python. And if you really want to get into the nuts and bolts of how computers operate, then you can actually make numerical weather models more efficient and make them do things that they haven't done before. So you can potentially innovate on that. But you really need the background in computer science in order to make that happen.